Now the final competitors in the pairs competition of the U.S. National Figure Skating Championships of 1985. Natalie and Wayne Seybold from Orlando, Florida, of all unlikely winter sports capital. They skate for the skating club of Wilmington, Delaware, trained by the well-known coach Ron Ludding.
Watch this, a split triple twist, a sloppy landing. One of those difficult opening moves that marked the beginnings of most pair skaters. Double loop side by side. And again, that dangerous and difficult move, a throw double axel. Here it is. Watch her landing in particular. It was a single one.
They're second coming to this final phase of the skating. Trying to move up past Watson and Opegard.
Lateral twist lift.
There's a problem.
You don't expect the unexpected in figure skating, but through the years, we've seen so many things happen.
Obviously, the little strap that holds the bottom of his pants down, it keeps it down, it has popped loose. Now, what the referee always does in a case like this is to offer, in the first place, they try not to allow the skaters to continue because it might injure them. He has the option either to pick up from here at this moment or to reskate the entire number at the end of the series of skaters. And since they're the last skater, that would be right now.
Dick, I think we have the moment of the accident on tape here. Let's take a look.
Watch particularly her back inside edge. Now look at the heel where the blade extends out behind the boot, comes right into his instep, and right there catches the strap and pulls it apart. But the point is, look at the height that she's getting on this lift, the speed that she's traveling across the ice. If he caught an edge, he could really cause a great deal of danger, particularly if he were lifting her overhead where she was depending upon his support and he caught an edge and went down. That could be very dangerous, and that's the reason for this rule being in existence, that they must repair their equipment.
Well, now it's time for a conference with Coach Ron Ludington to decide which option they will take. Remember, they can either start from the top or pick up where they left off. Obviously, now it's repair time, so let's take a break and then we'll be back.
You know what? It always happens to me.
Yeah, I ripped my outfit.
So now, with a safety pin holding down one pant leg, here is Wayne Seybold and his sister Natalie. They have elected the option of picking up where they left off. Remember the situation here. They're in second place, trying to move up, possibly to win the gold medal here. But in the other direction, they must hold on to second if they are to go to the World Championships, which will be coming up in Japan, because the United States, under rather complicated rules, only gets to send two pairs this year, not three.
Looking a little little bit sloppy here. The unison that they should have on the ice is not too evident.
Possibly because they picked up in the middle.
No, I think that's a little immaturity at this point. Sister Natalie and Wayne Seybold. And unfortunately, a rather mixed-up program from many points of view.
Yeah.
The difficulties of his skate, the difficulties of getting back into the program, the good things they did, some of the tentative movements that weren't quite so successful. And this movement at the end of their program, the back inside death spiral, very good lean on his part at this point. She's stretching down into the turn with a very, very, very a good stretch on her body. That's important. Nice position throughout all of this. Nice position. Well, here are the marks for your content. 5 7s, 5 5s, 5 2s, 5 6s, 5 7s. Really, the marks are sort of all over the board. Your performance seemed to be a little bit up and down throughout the whole thing, too, wasn't it?
It did. It felt like sometimes we just weren't on our skates, and other times it just felt like strongest it's ever been.
Why did you elect to pick up at that particular point?
Well, they gave us the choice of starting over, and we thought, well, we don't want to do that. And that was really where we started blowing the whistle.
Well, here are your marks for artistic impression. Very high marks and very good ones. It was quite an evening.
Well, it was. It's the longest program we've ever done. It felt great. The audience is great. No matter what place we get, I'm very, very happy.
Well, congratulations and good luck.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
And now the official results of the pairs competition. Gillian Waxman and Todd Wagoner moved up from fourth to third. They got themselves a medal. Second place goes to the Seybold brother and sister combination and the new United States National Pairs Champions, Jill Watson and Peter Oppegaard. We'll also have a look here at the finishes of the other pairs. And we'll be returning for live coverage. You'll be seeing live coverage of the ladies' competition. But the new national champions of pairs, once again, are Watson and Oppegaard. They'll wear the mantle that was borne so well last year by, of course, by Peter and Kitty Carruthers.